extra clothes. Do you bring them? Do I bring them? Let's talk about it. What's going on, backpackers and campers? My name is Dave, and this channel is called Off Grid. And on this channel, we like to talk about all things backpacking, hiking, camping, and gear. If you like those things too, please do me a favor and check out that subscribe button down below and that bell notification right next to it, because you can be aware every single time I post a new video. Now, today's topic is an interesting one. It is one that a lot of people can end up fighting about in the backpacking realm, particularly if you take one side or the other. And I think the overall general consensus is leaning one way over the other. But today I want to make an argument for the underdog in this one, particularly because I'm a part of it. And I will say that I am a fan of bringing extra clothes when I head out on my backpacking trips. And the reason for that is because of a lot of different reasons I'm gonna get into today. So let me make my case right here, right now, for reasons why you should bring extra clothes into the backcountry. I'm gonna get into the pros and cons of each here. And you know, it's an exciting topic for me to talk about. I was a little hesitant to do it because I know I'm gonna get a lot of flack for it from the diehard backpackers out there. But you know, in my opinion, here's my claim as to why I bring it out in the backcountry. So let me just get my style of backpacking out of the way if you're not already familiar with it. I'm more of the weekend backpacker. I go out there, you know, from Friday to about Sunday to try and enjoy my trips. I'm not out there for super extended periods of time. I usually don't go out for more than that, like 3-4 days type of deal. And I come back to reality after that. So I like to have my dose of dirt, and then I like to come back to reality after that. And, you know, so I'm not out there for an extended period of time. Now, obviously, if I was and I was going for, you know, a week or two on end, maybe I wouldn't consider bringing as much as I normally would as far as like my forecasting of what kind of clothes I would bring. But I think ultimately I would end up bringing more clothes, and everything in my pack is kind of designed towards cutting weight where I can so that I can add back those things that are going to make my time in the backcountry more comfortable. And one of those things is making sure that I can be as clean as possible in an environment where you're going to get dirty, you're going to get nasty, and that's just an inevitability. When you don't have a shower and you don't have access to running water and soap, you're gonna get nasty and smelly out there. But let me get into my list today and rifle through some bullet points for you guys. So the first question that I have here in my notes is, you know, should you bring clothes or should you not? What are the pros and cons? What are the benefits and things that kind of take away from bringing clothes? And one of the biggest things that you're gonna hear people say out there is going to be that clothes are going to weigh you down. That bringing additional options is just not necessary. You're gonna be stinky and sweaty and nasty anyway. So you might as well bring the least amount of clothes as possible, because you're just gonna be stinky. So you just have to accept it. And I'm sitting here today and I hear all these people say that, and I go, no. Like, I don't want to, and I refuse to. So if I'm gonna be stinky, I'm gonna be nasty, I might as well try to be as comfortable as possible when I'm in that position to begin with. So for me, ultimately I would say that it depends on the situation that I'm in. So again, if it's under 5 days or so, about a week or so, I'm definitely gonna bring a change of clothes for nearly every single day when I'm out there. So anything longer than that, then I'd have to adjust that a little bit or wear things more frequently. And I still do, even on my weekend backpacking trips, or certain articles of clothing that I'm going to consider wearing more than once, just to try and save a little bit of weight, but also because I know that certain articles of clothing can go a little bit longer without getting completely rancid, right? So if you think a couple of extra pounds is a lot when you're going on a weekend backpacking trip with extra clothes, if you translate that over into extended days, it's going to feel like a lot more, right? So it really depends on how long you have to carry that extra weight when you're on the trail as well. The next thing I want to talk about is that hiker stink, right? That thing that a lot of backpackers say, like, do you really need to embrace the stink? And in my opinion, you really don't. There's a couple of reasons for that. There's a couple things that you can get, right, so that you don't have to just smell like a wild beast when you're out there. The first of which is they have unscented deodorant, either in stick form or in wipes that you can buy. And deodorant is only going to go so far, right? Particularly if it's unscented. You know, the sweat has to get out somewhere. But that is one thing that you can do to try and abate those stinky, smelly situations a little bit. It's going to help a little bit, not a ton, right? But that's an option for you. The other thing that you can do is to bring an extra chamois or a wipe, bring some dry soap that you can kind of like rehydrate into a basin, kind of, you know, wipe yourself down with. Obviously bring the wet wipes, do a wipey shower as kind of like, you know, the bare minimum or a last resort to try and just wipe that grime off and that stink off. To me, wipes are kind of like key in those environments. Particularly because you're not always going to be near a water source or wherever you're camping at night. So having some form of wipes to wipe yourself down at the very least is another thing that you can do to avoid as much of the hiker stink as possible. The next tip that I want to get into here is going to be what you view as important. It's going to come down to what you as the backpacker views as important. So a lot of people, if they're going to recommend extra articles of clothes, they're going to say something like an extra pair of socks or an extra pair of undies are like the only things that you need. And you don't have to worry about extra pants, extra shirts. There are other backpackers who are going to recommend some sort of camp clothes as an additional set and/or/slash sleeping clothes. You know, so it's sort of like an additional set, but it's not ones that you hike in actively throughout the day. And they're still going to basically say, well, you can, you know, when you're at camp, switch to your camp clothes. And then the next day when you wake up, switch back into those dirty, grimy clothes that you were just in. But at the very least, most, if not all, even like the diehard Graham weenies are going to say, bring an extra pair of socks, bring an extra pair of undies. You can switch the undies inside out, things like that too. But to me, in my opinion, you know, I bring extra clothes. I definitely do. That's what helps me feel comfortable when I'm in the backcountry, so it's important to me. There's a couple exceptions there too. The two biggest ones that I can think of that I don't bring extras of are going to be some form of mid layer and some form of, you know, puffy or outer layer to keep you warm. Those two articles of clothing, I don't normally hike in anyway, maybe the mid layer, but those are two things that I will not bring an extra set of. But when I'm out there, I bring extra socks, I bring extra undies, I bring extra shirts, and I bring like one extra set of pants for a weekend trip. And that is important for me, and it is heavier. It's going to weigh me down by somewhere around the 2-pound range of additional clothes. But again, that's going to set my mind at ease. I save weight as much as possible in other areas of my pack so that I can, you know, keep that additional weight option for those extra clothes. And that to me is important to me. I want to try to see if I can not be as stinky as the smelliest person out there. And you know, it's not a beauty pageant. It's not, you're not gonna win any kind of contests, and I don't think anybody that you're hiking with is really gonna care after a few days what you smell like, because everybody's gonna smell like a Bigfoot, right? So, you know, ultimately, it's important to me. I like to bring extra clothes. And I would say, don't feel peer pressured by anybody else out there, either on YouTube, any other videos that you're watching, or people that you go out with, to have them try to manipulate you in any way to say like whether or not extra clothes are needed or not. So I think it's an incredibly personal choice to you guys as the campers and backpackers, and basically to say like, it's whatever you want to do. Your weight in your pack is going to be whatever you feel comfortable it being, right? You know, if it's an additional, you know, shirt that you want to bring because you on the last trip, the last one was so gross, you know, you look like Pigpen from the peanut gallery, right? You know, you don't want to be that guy, right? And you wanted to have something a little bit more fresh, then bring the extra shirt, right? So don't let anybody else kind of peer pressure you into saying one way or the other that you have to bring certain articles of clothing or not. I think it's an incredibly personal choice. And you know what, guys? This guy personally, I bring extra clothes, and I'm not ashamed to say it. I like to bring that extra, you know, comfortability when I'm out there. And, you know, to me, slipping on a fresh shirt the next day that I'm on the trail is really important to me, and it makes sense for me to do so. Hopefully this gives you a little bit more clarity if you were thinking one way or another, thinking like, oh my God, I can't bring extra clothes because so-and-so said that you shouldn't bring them and you have to embrace the stink. I don't know where that started, and I don't think that you necessarily have to embrace the stink. You're going to be stinky when you're out there, that's true. But does it mean that you should only bring one set of clothes, and you know, if you bend over and you rip a hole in your butt crack, then you have to hike out that way? You can do that, but that's not what I would really like to do if I can avoid it. So I do bring extra clothes. It is important to me. It might not be for you. Let me know what your thoughts are down below in the comments. Do you bring extra clothes? Is it an important thing for you to bring? Obviously, you know, certain things like bringing extra layers to keep warm are important, but what about those other things? Do you bring extra socks? Do you bring extra undies, shirts, maybe an extra set of pants? I want to hear all about it down below. I really want to get a larger consensus from the greater backpacking community, not just us creators and people making videos, but also from everybody watching the videos too. That's the big question. Do you bring extra clothes? And I do. So thanks again so much for watching, guys. I really appreciate each and every one of you. If you want to check out some of my clothing choices, I didn't really get into the specifics on certain articles of clothing really at all in this one. I'll post that right up here and give that a look if you want to have more ideas on what to bring. But thanks for having me. And remember, if you're headed off grid, make sure you do your research and you make it a safe one. I'll see you guys next week.